Hello, you are watching the Garden Corner Show. We are so, as you know already, where we're crazy passionate about everything gardening. I am J-Dog, John Karstrom, and I'm out here with Mr. Dave, and it is just raining and it is blowing crazy, but hey, we're undercover. I call it indoor shopping. What'd you say? Yeah. Mr. Dave is holding as still as possible. I want to give some quick shout outs to Karen Wallace Lawson. Hi, Karen. Lori Heitrich Sied. Hi, Lori. John Donnelly. John, my classmate and co-soccer player. We were on the same team together. Hi, John. And Mona Coleman. Mona is from Amarillo, Texas. And you dream of moving to the Pacific Northwest. Come on, Mona. It's great over here. And Dagny Andrea Elizabeth Adamson. Dagny, that's a great name. Anyway, thank you very much, and I hope you enjoy the show, and I hope, like I've always said before, that it brings something, it contributes something to your life. We're talking about lining containers, and I didn't tell you the last time about a secret weapon lining. And I want to take you through the entire steps. Okay, I want to tell you about the sphagnum moss. Now, we got lots of sphagnum moss because it's from Siletz River area here in Oregon. And usually you can find them. It's pretty inexpensive, $8 or $9, I think so. Comes in these little blocks, and you can get them in bigger blocks, and you can get them in these great grand big blocks too. Now, folks get these blocks and they take open they'll open up scissors wise with this loose moss, and they'll try to line a basket with it. So what they do is they say, well, I'm going to try lining this moss because that's what we're supposed to do. And you get this loose conglomeration of moss. And what happens is when you put the soil in, it starts to leak out and kind of run amok. And you say, gosh, I never want to use this moss again. But I want to show you a technique, if you don't know already, how to use this. Is what we do is we take this stuff and we wash it. Wash it in... I take this, and really it's just washing it. It's, let me tell you, it's a lot better if you use warm water, especially on a cold day, but cold water will be just fine. So you see how we're washing that? Now, once you have that, you can take pieces like that. I kind of squeeze it out, and I line your container that way. So let me show you just a few pieces here to kind of give you an idea of how this works, because I'm not sure why it is, but it really starts to pack in nicely. Now, on a block, you can usually get a basket done for one block. It might be on a larger basket that you do two blocks or a block and a half. So get enough of it. But it's really quite easy to line that, something like that, as you can see. Let me get a little bit more so you can see. Are you getting that okay, Mr. Dave? So you make it thick enough in here so that it lines it really well and you won't get any of the soil coming out. So I'm going to go on the next video. So let's try this, by the way, on an odd container that you have. So something like that. Say it's an antique that you might have, and you want to, you can certainly do a container in here, but if you wanted to do some moss, this is the way to line it. So you can go like that and create that little pocket without having to look around for that exact size. So let me get that real quick. So something like that, and then create that cavity. The nice thing about this moss is that it also holds in water. So there you have it. You just add your soil to it, and away you go. Does that help at all? my hands are frozen. I really used cold water on that. Anyway, I hope that helps. I hope that's a suggestion that you can use. If it isn't, here is the safeguard where you don't feel like you've wasted your time. Here's the quote for the day. Always be a first-rate version of yourself instead of a second-rate version of somebody else. Thank you very much, Judy Garland. That's the show for the day. Always live your passion.
See me right out of the sunset on the color TV screen. I'm